Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 8. Today I'll be showcasing post-processing steps using adjustments in the basic tone curve, HSL, detail, and effects panels. This is a photo that I could have but did not use as part of the weekly photo challenge contrasts. I thought it would be fun to work on for this week's post-processing efforts. Before I edit, I'm going to crop the photo using the golden rectangle and golden ratio overlay. So I come over to my crop overlay tool and click on it. And I am going to select the golden triangle, which is this 1.618 by 1. And the crop overlay has already been set to the golden ratio overlay. It's very similar to the rule of thirds. I use it the same way where I put the subject of interest at the intersection of one of the grid lines. So what I would like to do is take this section, intersection here, and just slightly move it over onto the middle of that triangle on the back of the pedicam. Very simple crop. Have it, click done, and there you go. Before I begin to edit, just one note, these triangles up at the top corners of the basic tab are highlight and shadow clipping indicators. When they change color, it indicates that some clipping of details has occurred. So I activate them to show where there might be clipping in the file. Highlight clipping shows up in red, up where you can see already some of the pedicab on the shirt in the street. And black clipping, shadow clipping, will show up as blue. And I don't see any here at the moment. So I'm going to begin by editing tone because you can make better decisions about color when the tone is correctly rendered. And I can edit the overall tone with exposure and contrast. I'm going to begin with exposure to darken this file just a bit. And I can come over here to the scrub slider, and I can drag right or left to increase or decrease or increase the exposure. And if I want to get really subtle in the adjustments, I can bring the cursor up to the histogram and click and pull within the histogram. It's, and I'm going to leave it about there, 0.44. Now I'm also can adjust contrast if needed, and to do that I'm going to jump into the tone curve. I like to click on the medium contrast preset, and most times I'm pleased with the results, as I am here. So I will come back. It just increases the tonal range across the midtones. Back into the basics tab, I'm going to edit now the light and dark tones with highlights and shadows. And these globally recover tones that are not as well separated as we would like, and they're effective in bringing out more detail in the darker or lighter areas of the file. Now, because I already have highlight clipping, as you can see, in the red shaded areas, I'm going to decrease the highlights using the scrub slider. And I'm going to bring it down until that red shading disappears. Where it did. Now I'm also going to open up the shadows here on the window of the bus and back here on the trees just to bring in some more detail. So I'm going to come over to the shadows slider and I'm going to drag that up. And I'm pretty happy with that there. Then typically on the histogram, I like to have the left edge of the data just barely touching the black clipping point. And blacks can be a little heavier if the areas that are clipped contain no meaningful detail. So I'm going to come over here to the black slider and I'm going to pull those down just a bit, bring in a black, true black point. just a bit more. Okay. Now I'm going to come back up and adjust the white balance. This picture has some very cool overtones, and I'd like to adjust those. One easy way that I try out first is I come over into this as shot adjustment. It's auto color settings, and I click and on the arrow and pull up the menu, and you see auto. And I'm going to give that a try. 9 times out of 10, it works well for the photos. And it does, I like the effect here. It certainly does bring in the warm tones to the photos. So I'm going to leave that there. And then I'm going to move into the presence category and increase the clarity. Clarity is a micro contrast adjustment that enhances the fine detail in a picture, and a good rule of thumb or a good place to start is 15 to 20. So I'm going to do right in the middle and 18. Next, what I would like to address is the color saturation in the photo. It's oversaturated for my tastes. And the saturation slider moves all colors in equal proportions, so it's going to decrease the saturation across the board. So I want to see how this does, and I'm going to bring it down pretty far. It's personal preference. I like the treatment of the people. What I don't like is that the saturation of the pedicab has decreased too much, and I want to pull my eye back to that a bit. So to do that, there's a great tool in the HSL tab, and I can adjust individual colors by using the targeted adjustment tool. And I'm going to click on that tool in the saturation, and I'm going to place the crosshair on the pedicab, and I'm going to click on the mouse, and to increase the saturation, I'm simply going to drag my cursor or my mouse upward. To decrease, I drag it to the left. And I like that. I'm going to close that tab. I can see that I have some white clipping, so I'm going to go back into the Basics tab, and I'm going to bring down the highlights just a bit more till I can get rid of most of that clipping. There you go. Next, I'm going to go into the sharpening effect in the details panel. And you see that it's already sharpened. That's because when I bring in my photos into Lightroom, I apply a sharpening preset. But I'm going to zero out of this by double clicking. And I will show you, I do have sharpening presets. Lightroom has their own presets, and I have a user set preset, and I'm going to use a user defined preset for my sharpening. And that just adds the general contrast, which is perceived as sharpness in the photo. Lastly, I'm going to come into the effects tab, and I like to use a post crop vignette. And this is a darkening or lightening at the corners or edges of the file, and highlight priority tries to preserve the highlight luminance. So this is usually my preference. And again, I have presets, and I have a few. I have one user. I'm going to try the smallest post crop yet. And for me, it's not strong enough. I'm going to go up to the Lightroom preset vignette 1. And that's a little better. And the strongest, vignette 2, I happen to like the most. You can see it's brought in just a little bit of shadow clipping, but nothing that matters in any of the details. So I think we're done. I'm going to go back in history, and I'll show you the original copy. There you go. I'm going to click off these tabs so that you can see it without the overlays, and here's the edited version. So there you have it. For this and other post-processing tutorials, please visit visualventuring.com and search for After Before Friday posts. Thanks for watching.